Could have been a Breguet, maybe. Definitely the same era, and definitely the maker is completely inspired by the master himself. Here is the movement, and if you look from a distance, well, it is an old movement, it is a pocket watch. So what? But there are different things when I zoom in that are jaw-dropping. Even for me, after 12 years of professional watchmaking, this is something special. Amazing book about Breguet, art and innovation in watchmaking. And that innovation is still visible today. Well, to impress the reader, you want to have a look at something really beautiful. So this is the first picture in the book to impress the reader. Well, it did impress me. We see immediately in a very old pocket watch, here we have a shock system, the parachute. And if we have a closer look, because it's not just visually stunning, it is real innovation. What we see here is temperature compensating timing pins. I'll show you in a moment how it works, but this is top of the bill, especially in that time. It is really, really something. And still, the parachute is still being used slightly different as Inca block or kif. And temperature compensating isn't really that important anymore because we use different materials for the balance spring. But how this works, it's a difference between the space between the timing pins, it is cutting edge. And now we have this movement. Here we have in a pocket watch the beautiful parachute shock system. And over here we have the temperature compensated timing pins. This is really, really top level watchmaking. Unsigned movement, but still. Even if we open it, do you see here the different types of guilloche? Then, when we open it, look at this. This is real engine turning, and I'll show you in a moment under the microscope why I'm so impressed by this work, because you can see the mistakes, and that means it isn't printed in afterwards. This is the real manual labor, including the tiny mistakes that makes it so beautiful. Perfection is boring, and I'll show you in a minute. It's really true for this one here. The start and stop of the cutting, you see they went just over the line there. So then we see this is real manual labor. The starting and stop is visible. Here you can see the hand cutting. Hand engraver. And remember, this is the inside lid which isn't visible. The outside is really nice, not nicely decorated, but the inside, there is so much work going in there. And then the information. It is a hand-wound movement, usually before 1850. But we see échappement, anchor, lever escapement, which is quite early. 10 rubies, which is a high number of rubies, of bearings, well, which is a high quality watch, technically a high quality watch, not just visible. And here, the rubies, and the compensateur, a parachute, the shock system. Technically really advanced. Remember, this might be 200 years old. And here is the capstone on top of the ruby. And all this here is part of the holder of the capstone. Do you see the difference in material? So you see the top is the holder of the capstone, and the bottom is just the parachute. The very thin escape wheel, extremely delicate, and then the pallet fork, which is important. Take a look at this, already with the rubies in between the pallet fork. Do you see that? And then the rubies are so flush with the pallet fork. It must have been so much work to make it flush like this. And in the Glashütte escapement, the pallets are still made like this. So if you look from top, you think it's a metal pallet fork, which suggests lesser quality. But then you have a closer look, and then you see the ruby in between. The dial wasn't attached. Hey! No dial feet. I'm going to remove the balance cock. And I really want to see the state of the pivots of the balance, because this ruby for the lever, the beautiful lever, there's something wrong with it, and the balance wheel isn't rotating. So, well, maybe it's visible from the other side, so I'm going to remove it in a moment. But here we see, is there a pivot here? Ooh. I just told you that this screw is of a later date. It's industrial and well, definitely less quality. Maybe it's touching the balance wheel on the other side. Here, I just removed the screw of the balance cock. So that one is loose on top of the balance wheel, but the balance wheel is still stuck, which is strange, because it's supposed to lay on the main plate. So the lever isn't. Then have a look at the other side of the pivot. See what's happening there. I don't want to stress the balance wheel, so I'm going to put the screw back in. It might be glued. So to protect the balance wheel from this side, I'm going to place this back and see what is visible from the other side. The capstone is sticking to the jewel, which is interesting in itself. There we are. Trouble in paradise. Look at this. There's a piece of the pivot. The pivot is sticking through the ruby and then like this. So the pivot is remaining the balance wheel in there. Actor, I think you're right. I don't think it's supposed to be bent that way. Just leave me alone for just a few seconds. There it is. Without making scratches, it is broken. It must be broken because it's hardened steel. It's never survived this. But it's straight. So now I hope I will be able to take it out. Now gently lift this bridge, and now I really would love to see, there it is, released. Spring too much, and there it is. And now let's have a look. There's pivot one. Hey, there it is. The other pivot is broken as well. Do you see that? The same length now. Oh well. And it's a completely modern way of making the double roller. It's incredible. Oh, and now from the top we can see. We saw the crack in the jewel, remember? And now from this side it's much more visible. There's a lot of shellac used as glue, as an repair, maybe a hundred years ago. But that can be so much better and nicer. Look at that beauty. So highly polished. Just well, at least 200 years ago. How you make the ruby is incredibly hard material. Diamond hardness 10, ruby hardness 9. If you want to make the ruby flush with the rest of the pellet fork, That is so much work. That is really not easy. And then the anglage, angling, and then almost black polish. An elegant shape, nobody is gonna see it. We look under the microscope and it's still beautiful. And we still have to clean it, there's a lot of old oil, but it is beautiful. So I think I stop now with the disassembly. The rest of the movement is free. Well, there's a huge amount of play in the mainspring barrel, but that's probably solvable. There is still a lot to do because we saw some broken rubies, jewels, two broken pivots on the balance wheel. So we have to make a balance staff. First, have to measure and look how this one looks like. But what a lovely, lovely movement. Beautiful watch case.